Hey guys, it's me Rahul, and I have something really cool for you guys. Have you guys heard about this thing called Cloud Phone, in which you stream the video feed of an actual device running on a server on the internet? It's like cloud gaming, but a lot cooler. It's a freaking phone on the cloud. So today I'm gonna be checking out the Redfinger Cloud Phone. This isn't a sponsored video or anything. It is literally the first thing that came up when I searched for Cloud Phone. So let's check it out. You may need to use a VPN to access this app on the Asian server if you are from India. By the way, this is a paid only service, but I have asked the developers for a code and they gave me one just to check it out. So I'm using this with the help of that code. When you are creating a new virtual phone, it asks for where you want the server to be, and that's about it. You have no control over which version of Android that you want to install and things like that. You have no control over that. So the version that this is running on is Android 6, so not the best version when it comes to Android compatibility, but let's try to play some games and check out some settings. So this is the UI of the Redfinger Cloud Phone. The UI looks pretty modern. Let's go into one of the virtual phones. It says connected to Cloud Phone. And if you look at the Android version that this is running on, it is Android 6.0.1, which is Android Marshmallow. Not that good, but hey. Let's check out some other settings as well. The first one we have here is you can use this option to switch between multiple virtual phones. And the next one is the quality of this video feed, that is the quality of the virtual phone. 720p is the higher that you can go, and I think it is okay. And the next we have here is the ping indicator. Then there is an option to full screen. So I go back. And then there is an option to volume up and volume down. And there is a clipboard manager to copy text from and to the native OS. And there is an option to exit this cloud virtual phone. So if you go to full screen, and here you get kind of this like one touch menu over here. It's actually pretty nice. Now let's check out some games, and I have already installed Asphalt 8 on this phone, so let's check it out. So the cutscenes are loading pretty okay, I believe. Whenever there is too much going on the screen, the video quality drops down. I can see some artifacts when there is too much on the screen, too much motion on the screen. But other than that, the performance looks pretty good. I mean, it's not the best, but okay. Okay. they haven't actually implemented a feature where it reads the accelerometer and gyroscope values from your phone and send it over to the virtual phone for gaming. So you cannot play any games that uses the accelerometer and gyroscope sensors. So gaming on this phone is a no-go, but the performance is actually pretty okay as far as I can tell. Like, everything runs pretty smoothly. I don't see any hiccups or frame losses or anything like that. If you guys want to check out some gameplay videos and kill montages, check out my friend's channel Petrolheads Gaming. Check them out and subscribe while you are over there. You are definitely not gonna play games on a virtual phone. It is not that good of an experience. So let's check out some other things. So what if I open up camera? So the camera opens up my phone's camera, which is kind of expected. I'll go back, and here you can access the Google Play Store, so you can install any apps that you want, which supports Android 6.0, of course. Then go to gallery. There's nothing in a gallery, and that's pretty much it. It's a normal Android 6.0 phone without any support for accelerometer or gyroscope, and that's about it. As you guys can clearly tell, this isn't designed for playing games or for entertainment. This is a cross-platform Android emulator that you can also access from your Windows machine, either by using the client software or you can just access from your web browser. That's where you see the use of something like this. It is not for gaming or entertainment. It is more for developers or Android enthusiasts to just tweak around the system and do some experiments. And the cross-platform feature is really the key here. You can access your virtual Android phone from a web browser, Windows, Android, and iOS devices. I wouldn't recommend this for a normal user. It is not that good yet, but if you want to check it out, go ahead. So that's been it. That's the Redfinger Cloud Phone, and I hope you guys found this video helpful, and I will talk to you guys in my next video. Goodbye.